Did you know that companies around the world have got software on people's computers that can ensure that that computer is kept safe, right? IT professionals like myself, I want to make sure that company data is protected, that the employees themselves are safe. But as a result of that, there sometimes need to be some software installed on the computers that can monitor activity that is taking place on that computer. Sounds like a good thing, but also can sound a little bit scary. Hey everyone, my name is Emilio. Thanks so much for tuning in today. As always, this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Hey, if you love this video, give us a thumbs up at the end of it if you did like it, and also subscribe to this channel, clicking on the button and on the bell. So is your boss watching you? Is your IT department snooping on you when you're online, when you're working on your files on your computer? Perhaps not. Let's talk a little bit about this. You know, ultimately, why are you at work? You're at work to make some money. And because of that, people that are employing you sometimes want to make sure that you're actually working, that you're not watching cat videos all day. So how do they know? How do these people know that you're actually doing work? Sometimes software needs to be loaded to make sure that this happens. What are some examples of this? Well, one could be a keystroke logger. What does this mean? Well, you're on your keyboard. You're pushing things on your keyboard. That shows that there is actually activity taking place on your computer. If you are potentially working remotely or working from home, how does your boss know that you're actually at your desk? You're actually working. A keystroke logger actually may let them know that you are there because you're actively using your keyboard. If there's no activity for a long period of time, it may mean that Joe, that Fred, that Mary is not actually working. Then you've got screen monitoring. Now this one can be commonly used by IT departments, especially when they need to perform remote work. Sometimes they need to log into people's computers to be able to diagnose a problem, to install software, to just do some basic troubleshooting with that user. But as a result of that, these screen monitoring solutions also allow people to see the screen of the employee. If one of the big remote management tools are being used in your organization, then it's common for them to be able to log in and see your screen, but you should get a little message on your screen letting you know that it's being monitored. And then the other thing is that a lot of your web traffic, right? Whenever you're surfing the internet, whenever you're going on your email, whenever you're working on instant messaging on any of these sorts of platforms, this traffic needs to flow through your network, but also through the company network. Behind the scenes, before your computer can actually get out to the internet, it needs to go through all these different layers. There could be software that is running on your computer to make sure that traffic is being monitored. Your firewalls allowing things in and out. So it's very common for IT departments to set up technology that can actually allow and disallow certain traffic. As a result of that, a lot of the web traffic sometimes can be monitored. There are proxies, there are all these other sorts of services out there that are meant really not to snoop and spy on you, but to protect the data on your systems, to protect the data that the company uses. So you need to just be aware that probably when you are surfing the internet, that the websites that you are visiting may be getting tracked. Now they're not going to be ultimately wanting to find you out, but if you are visiting a website that you shouldn't be, that could potentially cause issues with the company by installing malware, or a website that may be banned in your organization because of specific content, then that's probably a good thing. You don't want that to be allowed in to your business. So as a result of that, they need to be monitoring all of your traffic. Companies don't want to be snooping on you all the time. They've got better things to do. They want to make the money, right? They want to make the dough. Your boss has got better things to do than to be watching you. But just be aware that they could if they suspect that you're not working or that you're visiting things that you shouldn't be. It's there to protect you. It's there to protect the business as a whole. So how can you tell if you're actually being monitored, if you're actually being tracked? Well, firstly, ask. I would say start with that. Ask your boss, does my computer have software on it that can track my activity? Second, most companies will have what's called an IT acceptable use policy, which is a policy that sets out and lines out what the individual in that company is and isn't allowed to do on their computer. Ultimately, the computer, the software, the data that's on your computer is not owned by you, it's owned by the company. So the company has rights over that information. So in the acceptable use policy, it's not uncommon for it to state in there exactly what the IT team or what your manager can and cannot do, just to ensure that all of that is protected. So ask the question. Ask your IT department, is there software on my computer that can monitor my key logs, that can monitor my web activity, that can monitor what things I'm opening and not opening? If you want to look this up yourself, go into the application section on your Mac. Going into applications and see if there's any applications in there that you just don't recognize. In the very top right corner of your Mac, you've got all of these little icons, things that are running on your Mac. Down the bottom on your dock on your Mac, there's potentially applications that are open. You can also go and monitor your network settings themselves. If you're going again into the system settings, system preferences section, check out the network settings section in there. Are there tools such as VPNs installed or being used in your company? Are there any settings in the network or on the browser that may be pointing to a proxy? And a proxy being where all of your traffic, your web traffic, is gonna flow through this proxy. Verify things on the proxy, make sure that the proxy is allowing or disallowing specific content before it actually goes out to the internet. If there is a proxy in use, you should be able to see that the proxy itself is the gateway into the internet. Some of those settings are going to be available for you to see yourself. You can also check out your browser extensions. Are there any extensions on your browser, whether you're using Safari, Google Chrome, Firefox? You can actually monitor if there are extensions added on there that potentially have been installed by your company. Now look, work computers are very rarely private. Now, it could be for two reasons. One, they want to make sure that the employee is doing the work, but for the most part, it's to ensure that the computer is safe, that the computer is protected, that the company data, what's called the intellectual property of that business, is actually protected, that the systems are safe, that they're not, that employees are not accessing websites that they shouldn't by introducing malicious code onto their network. They want to prevent that. So as a result of that, every single computer in a business should have software on there to ensure that the company data, the company systems, are as safe as possible. Hey, why don't you let us know down below in the comments, what's your experience been like on using your work computer? Is there software installed on your computers? As always, I would love it if you gave us a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. Also subscribe, click on that button on the bell so that you don't miss out on any of our video releases. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next video.